your boots been under?
The recording, the recording setting hit single by country superstar Shania Twain. That's off the album The Women in Me, which is turning, if you can believe it, 25 this year. Lindsay Dunn, also turning 25 this year, or close to. She chatted with the award-winning artist and she joins us now. I could only imagine how excited you were, Linz, because this is Shania, the international icon, the living legend.
The queen of country music. Yes. And you know, this album has such a huge impact. I don't know if you remember the first time you heard it, but I was at a hockey game. And I remember when Any Man of Mine came on, people got up and were dancing and then, you know, breaking out in line dancing, which is the only time I've ever seen it. But we're really seeing the impact it has on country music today, 25 years later. Yeah. Like the current American, you know, Academy Country Music Award winner for Best Female of the Year, Maren Moore, she loves Shania. But I want to know, have you ever broken out in a line dance at any time in your life, possibly to Shania Twain?
You?
Unfortunately, well, not unfortunately, but yeah, like probably at least 10 times in my life, and that's okay, including one time in Disneyland when this song came on this time 25 years ago. And you know, this song right now, the number one added country song in America to country radio is actually a song by Carly Pearce called Next Girl. And she talks about, you know, the 90s country stars like Shania who influenced her and empowered them to write these songs. And then you have Post Malone, Selena Gomez saying how this album and Shania has influenced their career. And you know, when I spoke to the Queen, she said, you know, it's a humbling moment, but she actually gets told this almost daily from artists.
It's just a compliment to me. I mean, it's the best compliment ever. And this was just really my own pursuit in sticking to my own vision, representing my true self. And I think that my intentions are what really translated. And of course, music is the best communicator. So
it's so true. She was unlike anyone else at the time. She just came out so strong, authentically herself. She didn't try to be or copy anyone else in terms of her song, her powerful ballads and messages, and she owned it. And she resonated with so many people because she was being her, uniquely Shania.
Exactly. You know, she got some backlash for it, for being so outspoken, for writing these lyrics that mean so much to her, for the dressing
fashion
the way that she wanted. Exactly. And she even says that country music still thinks she's too sexy for them. But, you know, good for her. She did what she believed in. And this album, you know, took her and made her a global superstar. And unfortunately, she said she couldn't really enjoy the moment because she was so busy all of the time. Mm. But we've seen her body of work throughout the years, you know, how all of these songs, people will hear them and they bring them such great memories. But I asked her about specifically the song called God Bless the Child, and Shania spoke about how it actually is one of the most meaningful songs for her because it was actually influenced by a bear she heard in the woods that was crying because it was injured, and she related to it because she felt like it was alone and it reminded her when her parents died. Here's what she had to say about the song.
It was a painful inspiration. And I was feeling that way. I was feeling lost and helpless after my parents died. So that is what inspired writing that song. So that stays with me, of course. It's very, very, there's a powerful attachment to that one.
Yeah, she breaks your heart when you hear her talk about it. It's just, it's unimaginable. And that's just scratching the surface of the interview. We can see more on City News. Is that right?
Absolutely. And even if you go in right now and you even type in BT Shania Twain in the old Google machine, it brings up some of her other, you know, conversations talking to me about her single with Orville Peck called Legends Never Die, which is an absolutely amazing song. She's also was looking at some locations in Canada to film her new show. It's phenomenal work, but, you know, I'm excited to put on my best leopard print shirt, dance a little to Shania. You know, I feel like maybe you and Devo should do a little blind dance at the end of the show. What are the chances of this happening?
Grab one of those vinyl bad boys behind you, Lance. Get that thing going and maybe we'll talk, okay? We'll be back with more BT Canada right after this.